giving.
Yes.
But I would like to speak with you on a certain topic, which is part and parcel of giving.
Amen.
I will read with you from the book of Matthew chapter 25, from verse 31. But before we open our books, this has got a headline. This has got a theme. The theme of this sermon is titled, The Climax of a Human Journey. The Climax of a Human Journey. I want to assure you, each and every journey starts with a step. Each and every journey begins with a step. And our journey in this world started in the day when we were born. So, I would like to read with you from the book of Matthew chapter 25, from verse 31 going downwards. When you clothed me, I was sick and you visited me. I was in a prison and you came to me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then it reads, then the righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you a drink? When did we see you a stranger and took you in, or naked and clothed you? Or when did we see you sick or in prison and came to you? And the king will answer and say to them, assuredly, I say, you inasmuch as I did it to as you did it to one of the least of this brother of this my brethren, you did it for me. Then he will say to those on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and you did not take me in. Naked, and you did not clothe me. Sick, and in prison, and you did not visit me. Then they will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry, or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister you? Then he will answer them, saying, assuredly, I say to you, inasmuch as you did not do it to the least of these, you did not do it to me. And this will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into eternal life.
Amen.
May God bless his ladies.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The climax of a human journey. Have you ever discovered that you are walking? You are on the journey. But this journey is the journey going to heaven. We are all walking on the journey. We are moving on the journey. It's a spiritual journey. It's not a physical journey. As we are walking this spiritual journey, we are waiting the climax of this journey. We are waiting for the climax of this journey, where the journey will end. I'm telling you that on the climax of this journey, they are saying that there will be a throne of the Son of God in his glory. When we talk about thrones, we are not talking about chairs. We are talking about thrones. And when we talk about thrones, we don't just talk. We don't just talk about any throne. There are thrones, of course, in this world. There are thrones, of course, of presidents. There are thrones, of course, of kings. There are thrones, of course, of mayors in this world. But this throne we are talking about, the Bible has said that it's the throne of glory. It's not just a mere throne.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
be the Son of Man on the throne of glory, healing all the people in this world. The Bible says that he will gather all the people from all nations. The nations which we like most, they are the United States of America, there is Brazil, there are many nations. You know what happens? When God created this world, there are continents, six continents in this world. Starting with America, North America, and South America. Then you come to Europe. Then you come to Asia. Then you come to Australia. Then you come to Africa, whereby people, they feel that this is a cursed nation. But I'm telling you that on that day, on the final journey, the climax journey of our the human nature, each and every continent will be there in the presence of this glorious throne of Jesus Christ. I'm telling you that the world may deny you. The world can look down to you. Presidents cannot accept you. Anyone cannot accept you. Well, people cannot accept you. But on this day, Jesus Christ is accepting you. Then when people are approaching this glorious throne, it's not just any throne. It's a glorious throne. They are approaching even those people who are very poor in this world. They are approaching this glorious throne. Those who we have been despising, they are approaching this glorious throne. I tell you, I don't want to miss this journey.
Amen.
Then what happens when they are approaching this throne? What happens? The Bible has told us that he will divide them into two categories. He will divide them into two parts. The Bible has said that he will divide them. The other group will be on the right hand side, and the other group will be on the left hand side. The Bible has illustrated it that it will be like a shepherd when he is separating the sheep from the goats. The sheep from the goats. I'm telling you, he's starting with this part and parcel of the sheep. He's telling them that, come into my father's house.
Amen.
When they're coming into the father's house, they're coming into the father's house. But they're busy looking at each other. What has made him the King of glory, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, to accept us? He's giving them a very good reason. The very good reason, he said that I was hungry and you fed me. I was thirsty and you gave me a drink. I was in prison, you visited me. I was in hospital, on the sickbed, you visited me. You paid me a visit. I was poor in legs, but you clothed me. You gave me a clothing. Then they're asking, how come, Lord, we have never seen you? We were just reading in the Bible. We were just seeing your photos in the world. We were just watching you on the cinemas in the world. People were telling us about you, but we have never seen you in this world. How many of us have seen Jesus Christ as of now? We have never seen Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ, he said that I was blessed. You gave me a drink. I was naked. You clothed me. I was hungry. You gave me food to eat. I was in prison. You what? You visited me. I was on the sick bed. You came and visited me in the hospital. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then they are going to answer. They are going to ask him, where did we see you? When did we see you, Lord? Then he said, Then he said, come into my father's house. He's now talking with the last part. Those who were on the left hand side. He's saying that there are some things. I was hungry. You did not feed me. I was thirsty. You did not give me drink. I was in prison. You did not feast me in prison. Then they are going to ask, when, Lord, did we see you? We have never seen you in this world. Then the Bible is saying that he will answer them that you know what happens most of the times. Put yourself into this category. Those people who are in prison, they're the criminals. They're the ones who are doing evil things in this world. They're the ones who were caught by the police. They have been arrested by the police because of their evil deeds. They have killed someone else. They have stolen someone's goods. They have done or they have raped a woman in your area, or it might be your wife, or it might be your mother. They have raped that one. And the Bible said that because you said that he has raped my mother, I'll never go there. I will not visit him. He has raped my sister, I will not go there. He's too FCT at my house, I will not go and visit him. Then Jesus Christ is saying that it is mine to repay. Hallelujah. Then, because they were repaying this time, they were giving back, they were acting, not leaving it to Lord. He said that, I don't know you. I don't know what? You. Okay? When it comes to giving, I want to tell you that there are even people who sing songs. Songs which are secular songs. They're saying that God presses the hand. That what?
Yes.
God presses the hand. That what?
That gives.
That gives. How many in your life have you given something else? I don't want you to be standing up and answer. I want you to be asking yourself where you are staying. That how many have I fed in this world when I saw them? You have given us such a very precious time that you have taught us what form of human beings we should be in this world. You have shown us that, Lord, you want us to be on the best part of the sheep. Lord, you have done this before its hand, so that we should not say that we did not hear anything. I want to thank you on behalf of everyone that you have taught us here. Whatever we have heard the message from through will be our witness on the judgment day. Lord, there is nothing which is hidden before you. We want to ask your favor. We are not commanding you as of now. We want you to give us your Holy Spirit. When you give us the Holy Spirit, we should learn to give. We should know how to give. Because I'm not giving to the neighbor. I'm not giving to that one who is stranded. I'm not giving to that lady. I'm not giving to that woman. I'm not giving it to that man. I'm giving it to you, Jesus Christ. And this will be a witness of the judgment day. May you be with us. May you change us. May you change us, Lord, after this ceremony. May you change us. I will ask you, Lord of Lords, be with us. When I will be finishing this, I would like to ask you, Lord of Lords, we should give you what belongs to you. That thing doesn't belong to us. Because we did not find it by our power. We found it because of you. And we don't want to take it away from you. We want to give it back to you. I can see there is a lady there who is crying in her heart. She said that I've been sinning for this. I've been doing bad things against you, Lord of Lords. She's saying that she's crying to you because she has been holding grudges to people.
before. She has never given because she was looking on those people's deeds. May you help her, Lord of hosts, and cleanse her. There is also a man. We all here. There is someone else who gives but wrongly. He asks, he gives, but he talks, he posts. He exalts himself because he has given. Those people, you say that they are the one they have already received. We don't want to receive the one now, Lord. We want to receive it on this climax day. On the climax day of our journey, we want to receive it on that day. Therefore, give us a mind not to post when you give. In the name of Jesus, bless any offering. Christ is coming in this bread here. Lord, we want to ask you, not everything that comes to you is perfect. May you bless each and everything which is coming to you. But Lord, for my sake, not for your sake. Because you are a lot of power. You are above everything. You can resist things. But for my sake, Lord, anyone who starts to be given to you from today because of this message, I'm asking you for my sake. For my sake, Lord, that heart shall see miracles for herself or himself. That person will be blessed. Because of this message, I'm dedicating this message to you. May you show those people, may you show them that giving is a very good deed. When they give, Lord, give them more presents. They should receive more presents and they should remember this sermon. So that when they remember this sermon, they can take the message further to the end of this world. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are crying before you, Lord of hosts, because you never fail. Don't fail us this time. Amen.